right, everybody. This is your host, Seismic Bean, streaming Dadbot Gaming versus Naturally Dangerous. Ban phase is underway. Lots of things on the map already. For the blue side, for DBG, we have Amumu, Vayne, and Nu picked up. I believe this is going to be Vayne, Amumu in the bot lane, and then Nunu jungle. On the red side, we have Viego, Sivir, and Vel'Koz picked for 1-2-3. So far, I'm liking the draft on both sides. A lot of CC in the favor of Dadbot Gaming, just with this 1-2-3. Really excited to see what this fourth pick is going to be. 5 seconds on the clock, and it's going to be Kled picked up for top lane. We still don't know if this Vel'Koz is going to be a mid or support. Probably predicting Klug being on mid, so it could be that Vel'Koz on Klug. Klug, I'm going to try and say your name here. Klugschleicher. Oh, no, that was horrible. I shouldn't do that again. Emotes in the chats if you think you can say his name correctly. All right, this is going to be Ahri Malphite picked up in response to the Kled. also, this is heavy CC just to kind of like round out the comp. Every champion on the side of DBG has some form of CC or pill or engage. And I like the Annie coming through for the side of Naturally Dangerous. It's a really interesting matchup for both teams. Wow, some champs that you don't quite see so often. Nunu being picked up for jungle. Rarely see him in solo queue these days, but I definitely think is a very strong pick. I can always respect someone who's going to pick Kled into the top lane matchup. They're going to get this game underway very, very soon. And I might talk a little bit more about the draft. Interesting. They went into blind pick. hopefully this doesn't affect anything in terms of the in-game client and spectating the match. I don't think it will. Normally we do tournament draft, but this is quick, painless, straight to the point. So Mr. Trifecta is holding on to the Malphite here. We got Iruion on the Vayne. Okay, we can't see the red side names for the other team, but I can guarantee you they were lined up in order. So that's going to be Klug on any mid, and that's going to be a Vel'Koz support for the red team. Naturally Dangerous. A couple minutes on both teams, and I think I just kind of want to look at this draft one more time before we get started in game. at first glance, I think I have to give more credit to the side of music for the side of DBG on blue side. I think they just have so much engage, and with the Malphite, he can disrupt any team fight very, very easily. Now, if the way that the red side wants to play this game, in my opinion, is to have the enemy team funnel into you. You want to get into the chokes, hold the chokes early before any objective. It's really hard to walk into that team, but if they're walking into you, maybe if you have vision control, you can maybe make a cheese bush play, any stun, Vel'Koz knockup, Sivir sending out Qs, Viego ultimate. There's a lot of burst on this team, and really, if they can get one reset, they can really take control of any fight. I think they're really wanting to try and push a lead into the mid game and try and let that establish their way into winning this game. Otherwise, there is a little bit of late game scaling on the side of DBG with the Vayne, and lots of beef in front. So if they can't, if it gets to a point where the red team has to play into the blue team, well, I think it's almost impossible. They won't be able to get onto the Vayne as easily, and be able to have any control into any of the objectives if they're not there first. All right, well, let's see how much is on our timer. 17 seconds, we're about to hop into this game. So as you can see, Klug's on the Annie mid, November on the Sivir, and Hook My Book playing Vel'Koz support. We have Hook My Book subbing in. Let's see for who. Hook My Book is subbing in for, I believe, Nature Dan. Oh no, Nature Dan's in the top lane. Zach, okay, he's subbing for Will Brooks mid lane. All right. Before we get started here, I'm gonna try and make sure I have everything lined up here, and then we'll get this game right underway. Okay. Get this thing started. Looks like most of the team is heading into a 5-point. Freeze. was really odd. Okay, Viego's going to start on the top side of the map, starting on his red. Nunu is starting on the bot side for the blue buff, or starting on his red. And interesting enough, both teams are going to do this. Both junglers are going to do their camps leashless. Okay, early engagement by the Amumu. Going to do a little bit of trade. Not much going to happen after that. Invaded by the Viego. He's going to get some damage to the Nunu, but he's not going to be able to steal away that buff. Now fight one more auto is going to have Kled dismount from Skarl. Tizzy with the consecutive watch games, watch streams this month. Three consecutive streams. We love to see it, Tizzy. Thanks for the support. I know you're here to watch Hitmonbook make some plays here. Uh-oh, Kled taking a lot of damage here. Malphite might have a Q. No, not enough. Curious if a QE could kill him. I think this trifecta is respecting the trying to respect that he doesn't know where the enemy jungler is. Fortunately for him, the jungler's on the bottom side of the map. He's gonna take a reset, head back to lane. Both then a top, a gank, an attempt for a gank onto the bot side of the map by the Nunu. Nothing connects, so back to CS.
Malcolm, what time are you at?
I am at 42:23. Welcome, John. How you doing?
You said 42?
Oh, sorry. Four...
I was like,
I'm sorry. I'm at 4:38 right now. I will pause it in a moment, so we can catch it at the same time.
Okay.
Pausing it at 4:50 right now.
4:50, you said?
Yes, 4:50.
Okay, I am at 4:50.
All right, here we go. 3, 2, 1. Nunu's going to snowball his way in, and it's going to connect on the Klug, forcing his flash and ignite to the disengage. Two flashes by these ADCs, and a Q is going to reach and get the kill onto the Vayne. First blood over to the side of Dadbod Gaming. Or no. Majorly Dangerous. Vigo's going to start the dragon up here, try and continue to propel their lead. They're sitting at about 1k gold, a 1k gold lead.
No, I saw some trading going on top lane.
Oh, snap! Mr. Trifecta forcing out the flash by Kled. It's a lot of harassment into the top lane in the favor of the Malphite. Diego's going to execute to the dragon. Just not enough health and damage to be able to take it without... he was sitting on no items, so he hadn't backed yet. And I guess just not enough to be able to take the damage from the Drake. And it's actually looks like it was picked up by the blue team. It's a lot of aggression from both sides of both sides. And Young Gun made an effective gank. It did cost him his life, but that's more gold and kills into his mid laner's pocket.
Yeah, and since Annie got the kill first and then died, she doesn't get any stacks on her Dark Seal.
Yeah.
Annie's... Oh, do you want me to play by play, or are you comfortable doing that?
What are you most comfortable with?
I'm fine with either. So.
Whatever
you're more comfortable with.
Let me try doing getting the team fights if you do the play-by-play.
Sure. Alright, so you see Teenage Dan up here taking some aggressive swings at Mr. Trifecta. Mr. Trifecta, that's a hard name to say. He uses his ultimate, is going to take down Nature Dan to about a quarter of health. Nude coming in was going to gank that. We do see Viego right on his tail, though. He's just going to sit in a bush here and wait and see if he can... get a fight here with Papa Bear. Klugstress are coming over as well. Papa Bear has to use his flash to not get stunned by the Annie there. Young Gun looking for it on Hook My Book. Decides to go for No Not November instead. Young Gun hitting the second Charizard and No Not. And Rob using the ultimate here. Young Gun gets the kill, but Rob's still going for Hook My Book. Hook My Book walking back forward like a madman. Looking for the kill on the Young Gun. Flashes away, but still the auto attack goes through, so another kill over to Rob.
Just crazy things happen all across the maps for both teams. So much happened. So many flashes used, so many ignites used. The red team ended up taking Harold to kind of counteract a lot of the chaos that's happening.
Going in here on Mr. Trifecta, though. Does hit the bear trap, but nothing comes of it. Just for you. Well, we got a little lull here. I'm going to pull up the chat so I can see it.
Yeah.
Sorry for being a little late, everyone, but haven't been having computer issues, so.
I'm glad you figured it out.
Well, I think I figured it out. It's been happening every day, so we'll see if, says it's a hardware issue, as we see Mr. Trifecta up here taking a fight with Nature Dan again. These two just constantly brawling as a gank comes in bot lane, but Papa Bear, Hook My Book in the middle of this. Nunu is going to be taken down by that, and Mr. Trifecta having to flash out top lane, goes back in with the ultimate, hits Nature Dan, is going to smack him a couple times, and pocket pistol being used to get himself to safety, so Nature Dan living through all that.
Both these teams are just brawling it out throughout this game. There's just constant action. It's crazy how they started. I mean, at least for the good first 5 to 8 minutes, you know, everyone was just CSing.
Farmlands on the Klugscheisser here. Rob having to also use the ultimate, but nothing comes of that. We see another run by Young Gun using the Curse of the Sad Mummy here, getting a kill back onto Rob. Klushays are having to flash out away from Young Gun 18.
Young Gun 18 escaped with his life.
Yeah, surprisingly he got out there. So Nature Dan, he still hasn't backed after that trade. He really is Scarlbacks. We see Tibbers being used here on Iruion.
Rob Gear gets Bear, the kill on Annie.
Sorry, Papa Bear. Yeah, Papa Bear using the ultimate here. Rob getting the kill on Annie. Looks for another kill on the hook, my book. And it's crazy that that was tower range for Papa Bear, honestly. I didn't think he was in tower range, but what do I know?
Rob lives through all of that. He's now sitting 4-0 with a 400 gold bounty. He's going to kind of walk in here. Doesn't know they're on the Drake until now. And Saber's going to flash forward and hit her Q. He's going to get that shutdown. 700 gold into the pocket of a No Not November. Who's been playing very, very well. Jungler's
yeah, we haven't escape. Seen... I haven't seen a ton of action around the bot side because, you know, you have Vayne and Sivir who are both scaling, but now I see Zach XDR catching out Papa Bear, and it's going to just keep autoing him down. Hookman Books along with him is going to use the snowball to try and get out. Doesn't have it. Zach XDR ultimate and kills Papa Bear.
Clyde going to use ultimate top lane. That's going to force Mr. Trifecta to use his ultimate. Couple autos there, so both ultimates traded. I think that favors the side of Mr. Trifecta. His ultimate cooldown is going to be a lot shorter than that of the is that stun hit?
Stun looks like it did not hit. Klugscheisser though taking a couple tower shots, and we see more trading up here with Nature Dan and Mr. Trifecta, but nothing coming of it.
Yeah, for these ultimates, there's about a 38-second timer difference between these ultimates. So Mr. Trifecta is going to have his up before Nature Dan.
Also, I just noticed an interesting build by Nature Dan. Looks like he's going Heartsteel on Kled.
What is typical? Is it... maybe
right now it's a Ravenous Hydra Rush with Eclipse as a mythic.
Oh, Eclipse, yes.
Used to be Stridebreaker or Gore Drinker, but with the Eclipse changes, the shields have become huge for him. So we see more trading in top lane. I think that's just normal at this point. Rob going in, trying to get Klugscheisser, does dive under the turret with a Spirit Rush, gets taken down by Klugscheisser. We see a gank. Zach XDR gonna stun up Mr. Trifecta.
They're going to finish this? No, not enough damage. Bot lane sitting here with four turret plates grabbed up for them. There's so much gold being funneled into this Sivir. She's at 116 CS, which is definitely, it's 30 CS higher than her opponent.
Yeah, we see some pretty decent CS advantages for the side of Naturally Dangerous. We see Sivir, you know, having that 30 CS lead, almost a 40 CS lead, about the same in mid lane, and then a 20 CS lead in the jungle. So we see Herald being taken right now for Naturally Dangerous. I don't really get to talk about this in draft because I wasn't here, but like looking at these team comps, I can see why we're seeing a lot of skirmishing because, you know, you have, speaking of skirmishing, Rob coming up, sees that he finishes the Herald, gonna go on Zach XDR. Zach XDR has to flash out, gets Mr. Trifecta ult on top of him, and then Nunu is here, uses the absolute zero, doesn't hit anyone. Mr. Trifecta and Papa Bear just running at Klugscheisser. Klugscheisser having to use the stun, gets both of them. Nature Dan. Gonna fight Mr. Trifecta. Mr. Trifecta being really, really low, chasing after him. Does not get Kled as he remounts. Klugscheisser takes a Mr. Trifecta. Meanwhile, in the bot lane, Young Gun, he is gonna go on to hook my book and kill him as the Vayne ult being used and No Not November goes down to Ruion. And Nature Dan chasing down Papa Bear in his own jungle. And that's a dead Nunu.
A dead Nunu that is. It's crazy what these teams are able to do. It seems like these are a lot of comfort picks because they're really pushing the extremes. Nature Dan, like, going into the jungle and putting a lot more pressure onto Papa Bear and just kills him in his own jungle.
Yeah, really good macro sense there by Nature Dan to realize, you know, I think Nunu's going to try and heal up on a camp here. Maybe I can kill him.
Zach XDR taking that bot side turret. It looks like there's some action about to happen in bot lane. Young Gun misses the first Q. Second one's coming. Nunu Ball is going to connect. He's going to try and do as much damage as he can, but it's not going to be enough. Papa Bear picks up the kill.
Yeah, Nunu doing quite a bit of damage with the chomp there, and even though he's a full tank, still going to do quite a bit of damage because it's true damage, but Zach XDR not quite at the point yet where he could 1v2, and we do see a potential pick here in the bottom river, and Charm lands on the No Not November. Rob using the Spirit Rush, trying to get there. Ruion's here now, stuns, hook my book in the wall. Kulukstash is also here, kills Papa Bear. And there's just skirmishes all over the place. As now Kulukstash here, gets the stun onto Rob. Ignite comes down, ticks, and does kill Rob. Now more fighting in the top lane as Nature Din fighting Mr. Trifecta again. Mr. Trifecta having the completed item. Is taking a ton of damage, uses the Unstoppable Force onto Nature Din, forces the dismount. Nature Din having to use the Pocket Pistol, uses the... Violent Tendencies, there we go, that word. Using the Violent Tendencies back onto Mr. Trifecta to try and get remounted, does get it here off of a minion kill.
Just a bunch of 1v1s being traded by both teams.
Bunch of 1v1s, and you know, it's all 1s in the kills right now, being 11-11. I don't remember, pops the on the hunt here. Hook my book poking away. Everyone's turned off this Drake now. They don't care about the Drake. They want more kills.
Kled ulting in. It's just going to get him there. It's not going to be able to be used to affect anything in terms of a team fight. TP coming in by the Malphite. He's here with half health, so the red team could maybe take this fight. And that they do. Annie picks up the kill onto Malphite. Just lots of bursts. Nunu ultimate comes out. It's not enough damage. Zek XDR. He's going to pick up the ultimate. Pick up the kill with his ultimate.
Yeah, it looks like Rob here now, charming Nature Dan, using the Spirit Rush as well. Isn't going to turn anything. It looks like side of Dadbot Gaming just wasn't on the same page on whether or not they were going to fight or back off. As you saw, Mr. Trifecta and Papa Bear both walk forward and get obliterated by Kluxizers. The rest of the members of DBG kind of just sat back and waited. Also, yes, Super Hoagie, Nature Dan Kled is very exciting to see. I've been on the wrong end of Nature Dan's Kled. I believe Lippy would share that same sentiment, being on the wrong side of it. See Young Gun up here trying to 1v1 Nature Dan. Has Mr. Trifecta in the backline with him, and Nature Dan gets dismounted. Young Gun holding the Q. Must not have it off. Here comes the remount. Again, not much damage coming out of this Kled going hard still. Rob picking off Hook My Book in the river here. Where does he? He misses the charm, hits him with an auto attack, and kills him.
Wow. It just seems like there's always two fights going on at once. And you never know who's going to come out on the right side of it. this time it's on the favor of the blue team, and they're going to go ahead and start up this Baron right here at 20 minutes and 40 seconds.
Yeah, it looks like they know they're on it, but Clutchaser and Nonar are just going to push. Nature Dan with XDR go for a steal.
No HP. Zach doesn't get the steal. He flashed in. And that's going to cost him his life. Flash coming out of Nature Dan as he sees the Bane use ultimate. Klug and Sivir are taking down the inhib turret on the bot side. Ultimate coming through. It's going to connect. Charm by Rob. Nona is dead.
Yeah, slight overstay by Nonot, but do get an inhib tower for Baron, so gonna mitigate some of that gold, but now you just have to try and defend the pushes here, as they have, DBG has objective bounties available. Checking out some of the builds, we see a Tiamat coming through for Nature Dan now. The, Righteous, or not Righteous Glory. That item doesn't exist anymore. The, Radiant Virtue on Nunu, so is a very good mythic if you're going to go tank Nunu. Because you're going to be ulting almost always with your team. You're not going to be away from them when you do it, so you might as well get some healing off while doing it. Completed Everfrost and Shield Bow for Ahri and Vayne, respectively. And we do see a 10 stack Medjize on Klugscheisser as well.
Klug putting a lot of work for this team. Anytime kills are awarded to the enemy team, you always see him sneaking up and picking up one or two on the back end of it all.
See a fight down here, and stun and charm being exchanged between Rob and Zach XDR. Rob going to use the Spirit Rush out of charges now, and is he going to get Zach XDR?
He got his ultimate out. So ultimate's being traded for mid and jungle, respectively. Rob nearly getting the kill out of the kill on Zach.
And now they have to be careful. It looks like they're looking for a big team fight here, but Annie coming in with the Tibbers onto Papa Bear, but Papa Bear pops the ult, gets the extra from Radiant Virtue.
Check out the positioning.
It's gonna be a huge team fight here.
Check out the positioning of the Vayne.
Yeah, Vayne going untouched. No, not November. Pops the on the hunt. Is running away. Papa Bear trying to tank up a Ruion, dealing all this damage here. And Papa Bear gets the kill, but that Vayne positioning was immaculate in that fight.
Oh! Forced a flash, nearly losing her life. It was just frontlining into the turret, and Diego says, nah, I'm not going to let you do this.
It's crazy, the gold swing here. Like, we just saw objective bounties being up for DBG, and now four out of the five members of DBG have a bounty on their head. That was a 4k gold deficit to now an even game.
Okay, lots of damage, but too squishy, and you're too close to the enemy team. It's going to cost you your life. And another kill going on to Rob, who's now 9-4, 500 gold bounty. I can't tell if it was just that one fight or just a great macro over the last 5 minutes by the blue team. They're now seemingly poised to take advantage of this game and potentially put more pressure onto the red team.
Yeah, I think one of the big things in that last fight is that, you know, Klugscheisser used the Tibbers onto Papa Bear and about half-healthed him, but as soon as you pop that ult with Papa Bear, like, he's going for a tank build. He's not squishy Nunu like I do. Like, he's not crazy like I was. But Nature Dan getting the bear trap on a rope to Mr. Fact Hector here. He's really tanky, so you're not going to do a ton of damage. He has three members behind him. Huge ultimate under the back line of Naturally Dangerous. And Papa Bear's on a killing spree now, secretly just getting kill after kill after kill, and just, you know, with Mr. Trifecta just forcing the engages here. Miss Tippers from Klugscheisser is going to go down to Rob. Now, Zach XDR getting flashed on Mr. Trifecta. Mr. Trifecta getting some damage off, gets the assist. Orion getting the kill there. On the hunt, not available yet for not November, but does get away.
Well, unfortunately, the red team took that fight, and they were without their main damage source. So not enough burst to be able to get any resets, and they just can't play into the vein, especially without Annie.
Well, it's even hard for her to get to Vayne because you have Papa Bear and Mr. Trifecta just frontlining, and you know, you have a Nunu ult that you have to try and run through to get to him, which it's not just about damage at that point, it's the slow that comes from it. You have Mr. Trifecta with the Unstoppable Force ulting under your backline. Like, he's having issues getting to this Vayne in the first place, and so he's having to use his Tibbers on the first person he sees and hope that they burst him down. But we see Naturally Dangerous here go for the Baron as they saw pretty much everyone from DBG back. Now Papa Bear knows what's up and let's come in and see if he can do anything about it. On the hunt, used by No Not November, autos him down, takes him to about half health. Boomerang Blade used.
The enemy team has shown up. Rob
now is TP'd in. Papa Bear taken down by Klugscheisser. Klugscheisser finally getting killed with the Tibbers there, and Charge being used by Nature Dan. Here comes the Unstoppable Force on top of the Curse of the
One
Sun.
Reset.
Zach XDR. Reset coming in for Zach XDR. Is in Moomoo right now. Gets burst by Mr. Trifecta. Mr. Trifecta is just too tanky. And talk about Klugscheisser getting on to Aruion. He flashes there. Takes down Aruion. Or actually, Hook My Book takes him down. But now, Hook My Book, having Ludens, has to try and take down Mr. Trifecta, who unfortunately does not have any MR other than the boots. And that was a 4-for-5, so...
Wow.
All that because you started up Baron.
All that because you started up Baron. You know, what's crazy is it really just comes down to the positioning from the Vayne. The Vayne had to step up to try and sway the fight. And the enemy team tried they had a moment to be able to take advantage of it even sooner. But it actually ended up working out in their favor. I want to see more fights like that from the side of Naturally Dangerous. And, you know, before this game started, I was talking about the two team comps and how the red team really wants the enemy team to fight into them. They can't really fight into Amumu, Nunu, Malphite to try and get to this Vayne. So really, they need to be trying to get to objectives early, press this team to fight into them, and then okay, good flash by Hook My Book. Charm's gonna land onto No Not November, and that's a kill. More CC following up. Vayne flashes forward. Hook My Book gets his ultimate off, and he takes out the support. It's a 1-for-1 trade for Hey, DBG looking to press into this river. Let's see, ultimates only from Nunu, so maybe they're going to look to funk.
Yep, Kled. Kled's dismounted, though. Flash charm by Ari.
Zonya's coming out. And he's dead. Okay, reset. But you don't have any follow-up damage, not enough to be able to kill the Vayne. Double kill over to Vayne. They're gonna start at this dragon. Ari's gonna zone off the Vel'Koz here. It's gonna take a lot of damage.
Yeah, Yeah, and like we talked earlier about how this, or at least I did, I talked about how it seemed like DBG wasn't on the same page, and now they seem to be, they seem to have fixed that, and, you know, Rob says, hey, I'm going to flash charm this guy, and everyone just follows up, and they win the fight, and it gets them an objective, so, you know, we just see Naturally Dangerous trying to figure it out now, and figure out, you know, what can we do to get to this Vayne, to this Ahri, who are both very slippery, having dashes in their kit, plus having a shield bow on shield bow and mercs him on Vayne, so if he does get stunned, it's gonna be really hard to kill afterwards. Now I see Rob picking up a Dark Seal, having 10 stacks on it, so said Klug, you can buy Medgize and get stacks on it. I'm also gonna buy the Dark Seal and match your stacks.
And actually, Klug died in that one of these previous fights and is down to 2 stacks. Maybe might be able to build it back up if they can find a pick or two. Sitting here with Zonya's Hourglass. Ultimate coming in by Mr. Trifecta. Vayne steps up. Oh, Klug taking so much damage. Forced to use Zonya's and he's dead. Two other members getting caught out in that last fight. Diego and Kled. They're on the hunt to try and catch Hook My Book, who's just giving them the ring around. Surely he doesn't escape with his life. He might, because they have their eyes set on this Baron instead.
Yeah, well, I would rather take Baron than a kill on a Vel'Koz, honestly. But looks like Rob's going to try and chase him down now.
Oh, a lot of damage coming through and a shutdown over to Hook My Book. He's going to keep playing this backwards flank. Uh-oh. Here's a Vayne. He's really doing a great job here, just really being a nuisance to them. Okay, they get the big Void Worm. Are they going to get this little Void Squid? Oh! Naturally Dan coming in is not going to be able to pick up the kill onto a Mr. Trifecta. And another kill over to Iruron. How would you say his name?
I've heard him say it's Iruron.
Iruron, yes.
It's Iruron.
Iruron. Good comment by DHX here. Black Cleaver is a really good item, and honestly, if Kled had this item, I think he could easily split like one by himself. I don't know if he could take the Ahri, but he could definitely take the Malphite at that point.
Yeah, the build here for Nature Dan is a little questionable. Like I said, he has his Heart Steel, which I mean, he's got 527 stacks of, but I think if he had more damage here, as we see a pick, Rob getting charms onto Klugscheisser. Klugscheisser having to use the Zonyas. I think he's just dead, though. He is indeed dead. Rob taking down Klugscheisser in the side lane.
Solo Bolo.
See the other members here chasing Hook My Book. Mr. Trifecta ulting onto Hook My Book. Hook My Book flashing out. Papa Bear. Looks like he's going to get killed. Does not Mr. Trifecta getting the shutdown on Hook My Book.
Unfortunately, this is not what you want to see on the side of Naturally Dangerous. Mid laner getting picked out, and then your support to follow. And now they don't have the numbers to defend this mid inhibitor turret. A lot of damage coming out onto Nature Dan, and he's going to die. Mid-hit turret and the inhibitor going down. They're going to transition over to the bot side, take this inhibitor, and looks like they're going to go for the end.
They can definitely end here. They've got delayed spawns here.
Popped the Guardian Angel.
Flash Timbers by Klugscheisser doesn't hit any, or does hit someone, I couldn't tell who. And Iruron still having his GA popped, but, or not having his GA popped, and is going to get some kills. Looks like now the DBG is going to back out. Papa Bear looks like he's going to be the one to go down. He will not. Pops the phase rush and gets out.
Nice work. Lots of damage. Only one died, taking down the both turrets onto the both Nexus turrets. Two inhibs, two Nexus turrets. There's not much left for... there's not much that this red team has.
Yeah, and on the hunt and charge both being used at this Drake here, Papa Bear just going to have to back off and probably seed this dragon, but decides to go and does pop the ultimate, buying time for Young Dun to get here. I don't know if this is going to be a huge fight. There's no damage. Mr. Trifecta, all three tanks are here. Blue team does secure her dragon, and the fight afterwards, Aruion's here.
Vayne with the triple kill.
Late game Vayne.
He showed up for like 5 seconds and got all three kills.
Just the amount of stall because, you know, we talked about there's no Black Cleaver on any of these characters. Like,
not enough armor shred.
Lord Doms instead of a Phantom Dancer. Zach yep. XDR had the Black Cleaver. Nature Dan had a Black Cleaver.
They'd be able to do a lot more damage, especially to a team that has three.
Rip Papa Bear goes down to the Comet, lives the ultimate and dies to the Comet, and that is DBG taking game one here.
What a game. Just back and forth the entire time. And both of these teams really pushing the limits, but Dadbot Gaming coming out with the win.
I am Gert, whose Papa Bear came out, said Phase Rush MVP. Yeah, you only lived because of Phase Rush on that last one when you guys were running out of the base. And it definitely helped you get into position to frontline for your carries, so that's not very nice, Mr. Egg Boy. We don't point and laugh at people for dying to spells or dying to runes.
This is the part where we throw heads back and laugh.
Anyway, speaking of MVPs, as we've seen some MVP chants in this chat, who's your MVP for this game?
My MVP is perhaps going to be... I'm thinking it's going to be the Ahri. Just had so much pressure and so many great looks from... Rob. So I think I'm going to choose Rob. 14-7, if I can remember correctly. I can't see the stats anymore. 14-7 on the Ahri.
Yeah, for me it's hard to choose because other than like early game when you could tell they were obviously not on the same page, once the team got on the same page, everyone was doing their job. You saw Papa Bear, Mr. Trifecta, Young Gun, all three of them doing their part, making sure that they laid down the CC and layered it so that no one can move and that the damage could come through from Rob and Aruion. So it's really hard for me to choose, but I think I'm probably going to go with Rob as well, just because he had some really great individual plays that led to picks, which led to other plays being made. Like, we saw him flash charm several times and pick out someone.
Right.
But not to take away from anyone else, like I said, everyone was doing really well that game and doing their part. So, great team win all around.
Yeah, I mean, this is definitely classic ADCs don't win MVP moment, you know? Aruion, you did an amazing job that game too. So, really hard to say who would get MVP, but
Are you able to create a poll in the channel? Do you have editor or mod powers?
Yes, let me see what I can do here. I've actually never created a poll. Let's see.
If not, Hoagie can do it, or Panda. I know Panda's in the chat as well. You guys go to your moderator. I know how to do it, because I'm moderators of other channels, but I'm not on this channel. If you go into your moderator dashboard, you can create a poll there.
Okay.
If not, we can do a straw poll.
Creator dashboard. And then... manage poll. New poll. Question. Game 1 MVP. And we have... Papa Bear. Or wait, it was...
Mr. Trifecta.
Mr. T.
First one. Papa Bear. And then Rob.
Rob.
Aruion. Or you can put Elliot if you don't know how to spell that.
Alright, and the last...
And then Young Gun.
Alright, start poll.
We did it, chat.
Chat, tell me, how's the music? I have it playing. Hopefully it's not too loud. Hopefully it's just right. Let me know. Trying to be more like you, John, with your music and your amazing streams.
I wouldn't say they're that amazing. I just play music. That's all I do.
You're pretty darn good, if you ask me.
I know we had a Find Me Alpha jam session the other night when I was streaming. We just listened to songs of Symphonia until the game was ready.
Yeah, I hear that. Did you get the draft link?
No.
Here, let me make sure I get that to you.
Yeah, if someone wants to invite me to the game lobby, that'll...
Oh, yes, please. Here, let me do it. F11, that's how you do that automatically.
I wouldn't say that I'm a better streamer. You look at you having all the overlays and stuff. I don't have it all set up yet, because I had to redo my operating system a couple weeks ago, so I lost everything. So I haven't gotten it all back to where it was. I used to have it set up for PMA LCS. I had a separate one set up for Overwatch League. I have one set up for my personal stream. But we make it work.
All right, so looking at our bands here, we have Ziggs, Malphite, and Ari being banned away on the from the blue side by Naturally Dangerous. They're respecting the Ahri and the Malphite here. They're going to pick up Jinx for first pick. Red side is going to ban out Kindred, Varus, and Dr. Mundo. Looks like, yeah, they picked up Caitlyn and Blitzcrank. So that's going to be the matchup here in response to the Jinx being first picked. Let's see how Naturally Dangerous is going to respond.
This is interesting, because I haven't really seen Nonaut play a bunch of Jinx, so I wonder if maybe they're switching some things up, or if Jinx has just been on the back burner for Nonaut and decided he wants to bring it out.
It's a very strong pick, and definitely scales really well into the late game. So, I mean, that's something I would want on my team. I know it's not a way that everyone plays the game. But we're going to see Leona and Jarvan picked up to help follow up on with Frontline and CC for this Jinx. And Morgana being picked up here as well. So I wonder where we're going to see this Morgana being slotted onto the side of Dadbot Gaming.
Rob's pretty well known for playing Morgana, so I could see him playing this mid.
There we go. Okay. You know, I always respect a Morgana mid. It's definitely a pick that I want to play more often. It's not considered one of your traditional picks, but I think it can be very effective, especially with the cube bind duration. You hit the Q with the Morgana, Blitzcrank has an easy pull. It's money. Seraphine and Aurelion Soul being banned away from the red team, and then Mordekaiser and Lux being banned away by the blue team.
Granted, we see a Lux ban because we see a mid laner and a support already being picked, so I don't know where that Lux would go.
Yeah, they're probably thinking that Morgana was probably going jungle, but I don't know. Yeah, they clearly do have a mid laner and a support. So, I don't know. Maybe they just like really don't want to play against this champ. Zag's going to be picked up here in the jungle. Anytime I see a Zag, I immediately get a little scared for my team. Because these ganks, they're really easy to pull off. And there's lots of CC. And Zag scales. Okay, looks like we missed a pick here by the blue team, and Trundle's getting picked up. So it was supposed to be Trundle for pick number four. Man, Greg always invites me over. Wait. Okay, so it's supposed to be Trundle, and it looks like they're picking a Nivea as their fifth pick. So Trundle and Nivea being picked up by Naturally Dangerous to round out their comp. And I honestly like what I'm seeing. Trundle, a classic tank buster. It's going to be probably put top lane. And so let's see what DBG picks up to counter. It's going to be Gwyn.
Interesting. I didn't know Mr. Trifecta played Gwyn.
I guess we find out today. I don't know how that matchup normally goes. It's probably in favor of Gwyn. The magic damage and true damage coming out, especially like late game. I feel like early game, it's probably favored for our guy Trundle.
Yeah, I think actually Gwyn wins level 1 if she starts E. If she doesn't start E, then she doesn't win level 1. After that, I don't think she wins until level 6. And then from 6 on, it's kind of just a skill matchup until she can scale a little bit more.
Yeah. So Greg always invites me to these ranked flex games when I'm streaming.
I always get invites to games too when I'm streaming. Like, I never get invites to games, and then as soon as I stream, it's like everyone and their brother wants to play. I think I received 4 invites while I was streaming the other night.
right. So, you know, if I'm going to suspect something, I'm trying to think about how these team fights are going to be played. As I said, you hit a Morgana Q, that person could get picked out pretty easily. You could really play this this comp, I think, a number of ways for the side of Dadbog Gaming. So, like, that's probably one way. Like, if you hit the Q, Blitzcrank hits the pull. Caitlyn's probably putting a trap down. Zac is probably piling onto that one person. And hopefully that would be a really quick pick. And so, I mean, if that's kind of your reach in, especially onto the Cynivia Jinx here, if you're able to pull a hook onto Anivia, then that's a really good thing if you're a Dadbot Gaming. But I think the teams are a little bit flipped in how the team fights are going to be played from last game. So Major League Dangerous now have this death ball comp where it's like, hey, we want you to fight into us. And then Dadbot Gaming has this initiator style comp where they're like, okay, we want to go in, but this seems too hard to do that. So I want to see how these team fights go in a 5v5 matchup. I think it's going to be heavily favored for Major League Dangerous.
I actually think it comes down to execution. If DBG can execute like they did in the second half of that game, I think they actually win. They basically have a pick comp, and if they play it correctly and play it well, they're going to just completely run over this comp of Nature Dangerous. But if it's not played well, the Nature Dangerous can just, you know, AoE, Death Ball, run over them. Because they don't really have any way of disengage other than Morgana hits a binding and they all run away.
All right, they're going to start up this draft here.
Also, it looks like Fleeing Panda has opened the prediction casino, gambling, whatever you want to call it. So if you have channel points and you want to bet on this game, it's open.
Very nice. I think also from the poll, we had Rob winning out for MVP.
All right, and that casino is going to be open for four more minutes for Fleeing Panda. So it's a five minute pool there. So if you want to wait and see a little bit of the game before you make your choice, go ahead. But I think unless there's like something crazy, level one, I don't think it really change much.
I don't think so either. Yeah. Question. I'd like to run an ad here while we wait for our 3 minutes. How do I just start an ad?
There's multiple ways to do it. I know you can do it from the dashboard. There should be a button. I think it says it right underneath where the requests are. It should say run ad.
Okay.
Panda says he's got it. Got a 1 minute ad, so for the next minute we are only talking to subscribers.
Hey, y'all are the real ones. Okay, I know Tizzy's up in here. Hey Tizzy, say hello.
Actually, I haven't seen Tizzy in chat for this game, so maybe he's
Hoagie, Fleeing Panda, I know some of you guys, you are loyal subscribers.
Egg boy was here for a while. I believe he's a subscriber as well. doubt that ad's over. If you're not a subscriber and you want to see what we said while the ad was running, you can use your Twitch Prime for free.
Yeah, we need a lurk emote. So people would be like, ooh, lurk.
We can use our revenue from ads, get some more emotes. Everyone start coming up with emote ideas. I know we got some new ideas. I mean, Steve Ass has been around forever, and he's not even playing in this split.
Yeah.
Hoagie saying super hoagie emote.
I'd be down for a super hoagie.
It's crazy, emote. out of the four or out of the five emotes that we have, four of them aren't even playing in the league this split.
Wow. Yeah, there's the
Sean. Joe Mega Lol. You have Joe Mega Lol. I don't remember what the Frank one is called. I don't remember what the Dylan one is called either. And then you have OPTSM fan, just Sean. And you have Seabass. Oh yeah, Jungle Abuse and Rito Sucks. That's the names of those.
I got some emotes I didn't even know I had. Alright, looks like we're going to be starting this game up here momentarily. I'm going to go ahead and cool off this music here. This is the Echo Login music.
Back when new champions had their own login music and were on the login screen.
Alright, here we go, starting up. I'm gonna pause it at 10 seconds.
Okay, I will also pause at 10 then. Okay, I am paused at 10.
Alright. Make sure I get everything squared away here. Hold on, there's one thing that's been bothering me. Maybe that's not. Oh, yeah, it is. Okay, it is what it is. All right, I'm ready to start.
All right, count us down.
3, 2, 1, and we're off. Hey, classic. We have the Blitzcrank. You know we're coming through mid, and we're about to try and see if we can get some. Yeah, we force a flash off of the Jinx.
That's way more worth than usual too, because Young Gun has Hex Flash.
Absolutely. Hex Flash is it's one of those underrated items for me. Like, I mean, if I'm playing support, I'm probably going to take Hex Flash, unless like I'm an Enchanter or a Mage.
Okay. I see a pick coming out in here to Mr. Trifecta. Clearshots are hitting the stun onto him. Nature Dan is going to run him down. And Mr. Trifecta did start E.
He's going to escape with his life. You know, Mr. Trifecta doesn't have a flash. So I'm interested to see how that's going to play out for this game.
I honestly think it's good in a Trundle because you can use that Ignite to cut his healing.
That is true.
It's a little bit more of an aggressive decision, but if you want to actually like punish this Trundle and kind of put him out of lane and out of the game, use the Ignite early and you can maybe get an early kill on him in those levels that I was talking about. You don't really win.
I think it's like, you know, oftentimes you're going to see maybe Gwen pick Ghost to be able to, you know, run down her opponent. But yes, I think Ignite's probably a better pickup here overall as well. Jarvan clearly stole one camp from. Oh, trying to see what's happening here. So Jarvan is taking his chickens and doesn't know that his buff is being stolen away from him. Gets the EQ to escape with his life. And both junglers having stealing a camp away from one another. The red buff in particular. Ignite coming
Ignite
through.
Ignite come down.
Okay.
Well, little premature, but
yeah.
I'm not gonna put it too much on Mr. Trifecta. He's still relative new to the game, you know.
Right. Nice bind coming through. Rob's gonna be out of mana now though. I don't know if y'all can hear my cat. My cat just keeps meowing at me.
I heard him a little bit ago, but I haven't heard him since, so.
Gotcha. He may be hungry. I don't know if my sister fed him. Alright, I'm gonna feed him really quick.
Alright.
Wait, no. He's been fed. I remember.
Fight going down bot lane. Flash being used by Hook and Book. Flash stuns Aruna. Aruna has to respond with his own flash. Young Gun ignite, holding on to the ignite for now. Hook my book, getting autoed by Young Gun. Stuns up Young Gun. Papa Bear here now. Misses the jump on a donut November. Misses the stretching strikes as well. Hook my book out of mana. Missed hook by a Young Gun 18.
This is insane. They all escaped with their life. I actually saw an angle there where November, if he stepped up into that 3v1, he might have been able to pick up that Caitlyn really quickly, and then he would have had the excitement to be able to probably pick up the Blitzcrank as well. But honestly, you're gonna take both of you living when you see the enemy jungler come into your lane. Hook my book playing that very, very well, dodging everything.
I don't think any skill shots hit in that bottom fight. I think everyone dodged everything.
clearly that warrants the question is like, are we all really good or are we all really bad? I think we're all really good here. It wasn't like people were walking in a straight line and just missing. Definitely.
No, there was no one. There was no one walking in straight lines in that fight. So, could have been definitely lower skill, but I think we were all pretty good. Mr. Effect, I think six here. Turned on not having any mana. Now, Young Gun pulls Hook My Book back onto a Caitlyn trap. First blood going over to Rob.
Ultimate coming out from Mr. Trifecta, and they're gonna keep staying the Drake. Yeah, they're just gonna pull it out. So first blood going over to. I got the teams mixed up on the stream. Let me fix that really quick. Dadbot Gaming. First kill going over to Dadbot Gaming. And. First Drake going over to Dadbot Gaming.
I see you.
Mm-hmm. Well, we still see about a 600 gold lead in the favor of Naturedly Dangerous, and this is something that we saw in the previous game. Just the laning was in a much better position for Naturedly Dangerous into these matchups, and that's definitely something you want to see into this game, especially when you're a scaling team. You want to stay ahead in CS, you want to stay ahead in farm. Okay, a lot of damage coming out. One more auto. Oh, not quite.
Popovir blocks the Jinx rocket. Jinx actually flashing, trying to get the Caitlyn kill. Oh, is going to walk into tower range and double kill, going to Young Gun 18.
If you're Naturedly Dangerous, you're definitely thinking, at least it's on the Blitzcrank.
Zac XDR coming in for a gank on Rob here. Wall goes up. Rob popping the ultimate. Is gonna Klugchess just gonna flash out. Zac XDR just go ahead and tanking it up. Takes a tower shot. Now is walking away as Rob chases him. Has to flash the Dark Binding.
Some plays made, and then some
counter plays. You see Trundle ultimate actually being used on Mr. Trevect up here. Has to use the Hallowed Mist to run away, and does just use the skip and slash to get out.
A lot of aggression all over the map yet again. Both of these teams, it feels like they're at each other's necks, you know? any opportunity, if they have to do some damage, or look at this, Nature Dan just, like, anytime you step up, I'm just going to start whacking you. Like, this is how I want to play.
I mean, he is playing the right champions, playing Kled and Trundle, playing the right champions to do that, so. Wouldn't want to see him play, like, you know, Sion. I guess Sion could do the same thing, but, like, you know, any tank like Maokai, like, you don't want to just trade autos on Maokai and go balls to the wall.
Right. I like the Tiamat pickup here. Just helps with your farm and your wave management. Forces you to kind of be on the pushing side, but I mean, you're definitely that's what you want to do as Trundle. Jarvan gonna EQ and hit the ultimate, and kill's gonna go over to Zac XDR.
Yeah, you can kind of see it there. Is Mr. Trifecta used the ultimate. He actually got quite a bit of health back, but just isn't quite scaled enough yet and have enough items to really turn that fight. If that fight happens in a couple levels from now, like, say probably level 11 or so, right, like, that's a completely turnable fight. As we see Rob using the chains here to stun up Klugchaser, flashed by Young Gun, does knock up Klugchaser, and gonna get the egg in the...
And Young Gun held his Q, so...
See Papa Bear coming in on Zac XDR on his Gromp here. Flashes to get the knockup, but doesn't quite take down Zac XDR. Now Nature Dan here just whacking away at him, but does have Mr. Trifecta on the way.
Well, Zac XDR gets out, still living. Zac is forced to flash because of the presence of the Trundle. So here we go. Blitzcrank walking up. Is he going to use his Q? I mean, absolutely. Jinx is just stepping up here. Oh. Ultimate coming out, and that's going to be a kill over to Irion. 1-0 and 3 on the bot lane. Honestly, I think Nonot was really hoping that he was going to be able to get a kill there, that Irion wasn't actually there. Also, I don't think they're respecting the damage from the Blitzcrank ultimate.
Speaking of damage, hook my book going on here, and has to flash away from the Young Gun 18 hook.
Solid ultimate.
Solar Flare, though, and Cataclysm comes in onto Irion, and two shutdowns collected there.
Hook my book with an insane ultimate. I need to get better at knowing these note names. The Solar Flare. He connects them to both members, and perfect lineup for Zac XDR to just swoop in and score with his ultimate. the Cataclysm. Jinx Rocket nearly hit both of them too. And if it did, I think Jinx would have actually picked up the kill into the Caitlyn.
Yeah, a lot of playing Jinx is, as we see Papa Bear going up here and hit the stretching strikes on a Nature Dan, doesn't pull him back though, pops the Herald. That was taken, I think, during that whole bot fight.
Ultimate coming out.
Ult being used by Mr. Trifecta, trying to clear out the wave here so that the Herald does get a charge, and it will get a charge, and we see plate money going over to both Mr. Trifecta and Papa Bear.
Okay.
Another Dark Binding landing onto Zac XDR. Chains coming out is going to stun up Zac XDR. Doesn't have anything else. Young Gun 18 here again. Does not hit the hook onto Klugscheisser. Yeah, that's the dangerous part about giving Blitzcrank two kills early, is that he gets those mobility boots, yep, and then he's just all over the map.
Yep.
So, you know, you're glad that Caitlyn doesn't get the money, but then your mid laner is not going to be very happy, and we see Nature Dan execute for the turret.
Yeah, he's just taking the quick back, you know. Actually, it's a long back, as it's a 30-second death timer.
Do you see Cloud Drake being up here now? So, probably going to see some fighting over this as we see Hook My Book clearing out Vision.
No Not
here comes up. Young Gun. Just runs past Hook My Book, trying to get to No Not November. Has to end up. No. Okay, I've Hook My Book. Zac XDR is now here, so this is a 3v3. Papa Bear having the passive, though. Young Gun running the opposite way of his team, but does get out. Rob now here, so another. Error coming, and Klugscheisser's on the way. It's going to be a full blown 4v4. Young Gun missing the hook. Zac XDR. EQs over the wall, and there's the Cataclysm. Does kill Young Gun. Gonna get Papa Bear's passive here. A double kill over to Zac XDR. Hook My Book still looking for more. I don't think you want this. Your team's not here, Brandon. Does get bound up by Rob.
He's not gonna hit. But he has to die here. He's just stalling for his team, I suppose. A Binding's going to hit onto the Jinx. Oh, Blitzcrank's coming up.
Good cleanse by No Not November, but probably bad usage of the ultimate as it stops him from getting away. Also, chat is asking for objective timers. Malcolm.
Okay.
See Dark Binding. Yes. If you can do that, I'll cast for a minute. Rob hitting a Binding here. Young Gun again. It's mid, takes up three tower shots, going down, being executed because the egg can't do any damage. Rob now, is he going to get Klugscheisser or Zac XDR? Yes, he does. Rob, trying to take out Zac XDR now, has Nature Dan chasing him. I'm going to get pillared. Here comes Papa Bear, takes out Zac XDR for that, and gets Solar Flare again by Hook My Book. We see supports all over the place. Subjugate also being used on Papa Bear, gets exhausted, has to flash out. Does get the jump out, lives. Jumps towards his top laner and looks like he's out. So overall, two for two fight. Now Mr. Trifecta is going to take his chances and fight Nature Dan and Hook My Book. Does get stunned up, probably overstepped here. Nature Dan takes out Mr. Trifecta.
This is definitely a Clown Fiesta. It's like a Clown Fiesta in all the right ways, though. It's like everyone's making the play, and then they're able to counterplay somehow, in some fashion, especially looking at Papa Bear just swooping in and getting the shutdown onto Zac XDR. Another play being made here. Rob picks up the kill onto Nature Dan. Anivia just getting so much damage onto Rob. Is he going to die? Not quite yet. He's still alive. He does end up losing his life, but two kills go over to the side of Dadbot Gaming. And look! Zac XDR, he's not done yet. And one more kill going over. One for one trade made for both teams.
And the craziest part is all this action, the ADCs aren't getting any of these kills.
Yep.
Jinx is 0-3-1 and Caitlyn at 1-1-6, so Caitlyn being a little bit more part of these fights, but still not picking up any of them. It's on Young Gun and it has three of them, and you see Garibear having two kills, which isn't necessarily too many on Zac, because, you know, you get them from ganks, but...
You know, if... I'm not sure if... I don't think Jinx Rocket was used at all during that those fights, and, you know, that's how you kind of get involved if you're not going to be able to be in the fight. We kind of saw that a little bit earlier whenever Zac XDR was making some trades with Blitzcrank on the bot side of the map. I was like, man, like, a Jinx Rocket right here, it would have killed the Blitzcrank. Okay, it looks like Nature Dan's going to be using his ultimate to flash forward and gets the chomp onto the Gwyn. Okay, another trade happening.
Fighting everywhere.
Wow. 1-for-1, 2-for-1. Just all over the map. I have to zoom out here. You can see both fights happening here on the map. Nearly another 1v1 trade, but this time it's going to be Jinx picking up a double kill. I don't know. Is it me, or didn't we just see this game at like 13-7 or 13-9? And now it's 13-14. They're going to be able to get that first tier turret, and they're going to get the second tier turret before the Herald's going to crash in. Now we got a full health charge that's going to crash into this in-hit turret on mid lane.
Good disengage there by Nature and Dangerous, knowing that, you know, you have Blitz and Papa Bear both coming up. So you got to get out before they engage on you, and you just cause another fight where, you know, it goes back and forth. It seems like this game has been very back and forth. You see one team starting to take a lead, and then all of a sudden the other team takes a really good fight and gets the kills back and takes another lead, so.
Oh! The flash Q almost hits onto Not November, but he uses his flash. And Blitzcrank dies. Mr. Trifecta trying to escape with his life, but a double kill goes over to Trundle. Jinx is yet again getting a lot of damage out. Ultimate comes through. Zac passive being popped. Hook My Book is low. Ultimate coming out, and it's going to connect. Irion picks up a kill to kind of hopefully level out the deaths that is happening on his team. Rob, finding himself in a very difficult position here, is going to get walled off here. Trundle, Biller coming through. Q-Bind's going to connect, and Rob is going to be able to escape here. Pick up a Dark Harvest stack, too. Caitlyn's going to join here, and so is Blitzcrank. Q-Binding hits. Trundle is dead. Shutdown going over to Caitlyn. This is exactly what you want to see. Another shutdown over... Q-Bind hits, Egg pops, and get this kill over to Caitlyn. Yes. He's now 5-1.
Yeah, we were just talking about how the ADCs were getting kills, and now you see 3 kills on Jinx, 5 kills on Caitlyn.
What is going on? This game is just back and forth. Constant fights, constant action. If there's an objective, they're fighting for it. If there's a, if there are Krugs up, they're fighting for it.
if they see any reason to fight, they are fighting for it. They will fight over vision, they will fight over objectives, over jungle camps, over lane minions.
Oh man, it's you see the game going in one side, going the one favor, and you're like, wow, okay, cool. Like, I mean, Jinx just got a triple kill. Like,
oh, we see Hook My Book disconnecting.
Oh, they're gonna pause for this? Okay, he's reconnected. I guess it wasn't too serious. You know what? I think they did pause, but because we're on the delay, we don't get to see that happen. Kind of cool real-time feature there for us. Okay, Zek XDR is going to steal over this... I kind of froze here. Did you freeze?
Yeah, I froze for a second as well.
Okay, cool. All right, I'm back. Okay, Zach XDR is going to skip this live. Trundle Ultimate coming out. He's going to push Mr. Trifecta onto his bottom turret, and I can tell, just like those pauses and glitches for us, it's probably affected how those fights were being played out. Hook My Book disconnecting again has reconnected, and he's going to die. Zach Pop onto Hook My Book. That's really unfortunate. Hook clearly
I'm thinking there was probably another... I bet there was another pause there, and it skipped it for us.
Yeah.
Well, what time are you at? Just to make sure that after all this stuff, we're still at the same time.
I'm at 2:51.
Yeah, I'm at 55, 56, 57. Okay. I think we're...
You might be like a half second ahead of me or something.
Okay.
It's not a big deal. Okay, Rob is going to be chasing down Nature Dan. Cubine's going to hit. The TP's coming out. It looks like that's going to be a Nivea. Mr. Trifecta using his ultimate. A stun coming through. Nature Dan just got deleted. Mr. Trifecta's online.
Mr. Trifecta scaling.
Only with an Ashes Tooth at this point,
too. He almost has Riftmaker done.
Yeah.
I bet you after those kills, he has the money for Riftmaker and Boots.
And Boots, yeah. I'm probably going to want to see either Merc Treads or...
Looks like he's going Tabbies.
Yeah, or Tabbies.
Yeah, because, I mean, every kind of CC, you can dodge the Hallowed Mist, so...
This is a bad idea.
Fight over Baron.
Leon Ultimate coming through. Lots of damage coming through. Jinx is bound. Can you get some autos off? Yes. Reset. Okay. Drake coming over to the red side. A TP coming down. Hook My Book getting... Oh, another EQ combo. If Rob dies here, that's all Baron. All four... all members dying. So Baron not being saved... on the side of Dadbod Gaming.
Huge GA purchase there by Zach XDR before that fight, by the way.
Yes.
You don't typically see it second, but in that instance it worked. He knew there was lots of fighting going on and that it'd be useful.
I mean, if you're going to play to fight as much as they are, then, I mean, you're probably going to be trying to pick up things that are going to keep you alive for longer. I'm still just like extremely surprised that yet again this game literally just keeps swinging back and forth with who's in control, you know. But now we're seeing a clear 3k gold lead into the side of naturally dangerous, as they're trying to contest vision onto this bot side of the map to control Drake spawning here, and it looks like they're doing a great job getting some damage off onto Papa Bear. Papa Bear is going to re-engage here. EQ combo coming out, ultimate coming through by Papa Bear. He's still alive. Nature Dan might die here. He's dead. Gwyn snipping away. Hook My Book is also going to go down. Papa Bear with another kill. And here we go. Wasn't it just...
It's just a 3k gold lead. Now it's about 1k. Well, 1.5.
Back and forth.
And again, we see Radiant Virtue going on to Papa Bear here. Huge for team fights, and there's lots of fighting going on, so... Might as well build Radiant Virtue.
Yeah.
I mean, that's what caused him to live so long, because the changes to Radiant Virtue, giving yourself more maximum HP when you activate it now, lets you live for that little bit longer.
Yeah. Yet again, I'm surprised with how this game is going. Hook my book disconnecting yet again. Really, really sad to see that he's having issues the way he is. We're actually going to get this pause timer through, so we're probably catching up to their game on the stream. So, wow. So, tell me, what are you thinking about the state of this game? General Dill, we're on game two.
DBG won game one, also General Dill. I mean, I wouldn't say I'd rather see this than, you know, like, a slow game, but having two kills a minute is, casting-wise, it's a little crazy, but, like, I'm sure playing, like, I love going fast.
Yeah.
And that's how they're playing. And so, I don't think it's necessarily, again, it's not necessarily bad for either team, but I think if it was going to favor someone, it favors the comp of Naturally Dangerous, just because they have that death ball comp. But we do see the picks constantly coming out from the side of DBG, so that's why we're seeing this huge back and forth instead of a, you know, decisive team fight win from one team or the other.
I think I'm going to give a lot of credit to this Blitzcrank, who, and also Rob, I think their combo of just being able to they're Naturally Dangerous is getting a pick or getting a kill here, but they're able to disrupt and stun and CC whichever target they just want to burst down, and then Irion is just getting so much damage, and then Mr. Trifecta is just able to come in and just slice his way through the front line and into the back line. So this is a really exciting game to watch. I couldn't agree with you more, though. I as the time creeps later and later, I'm looking at Naturally Dangerous to kind of pull ahead even further and maybe winning this game.
Yeah, and we already see, like, the Jinx 2-item power spike coming in, and it looks like he is going to go for a Lord Dom's this time, so should be able to cut through Papa Bear pretty easily. But definitely what you were saying about Young Gun and Rob just pulling the trigger and being able to play around each other and then have Papa Bear come in afterwards, so you kind of have this, you know, three-pronged attack of, like, you know, you dodge the binding, dodge the hook, dodge the Zac engage, like what are you gonna do? And then, you know, you have Trifecta and Irion riding the damage.
It's really interesting. I mean, the Caitlyn has the range to be able to just kind of sit back, poke from afar. Jarvan maybe trying to, like, go into this fight, but they're really trying to play peel. So if you're not getting this damage front to back and you're just getting poked and chipped away, it just makes it that much more difficult to kind of survive and protect this Jinx. I can't tell you what the outcome's going to be. I'm just excited to kind of continue to see how these things are going. I also want to note that Dadbot Gaming has picked up 3 Drakes. So they're on Soul Point, picking up the last 2 Fire Drakes as well. So I think that's going to be a really big ticker for us. And, you know, Drake's spawning in 4 minutes. So when we resume play, we're probably going to continue to see a lot of fights, but, you know, the fight around the Drake is the one that's going to matter right here, right now. If you're on the side of Dadbot Gaming, you need to pick up this Drake so you can continue to press this game to be in sooner rather than later.
Yeah, especially because the Infernal Soul benefits a poke comp and a pick comp, because they get the burst off of that, so. And hopefully we get Hook My Book back in here. They do have, just as a reminder for everyone, they do have 15 minutes of pause time they can use, and then the opposing team can decide to give them more of their time if they want, or they can say, no, let's play on. So.
(clears Yeah, does that timer, what does it start at? 30 minutes?
Yeah, the timer starts at 30 minutes. It's been about 6 minutes or so. It's also crazy that you can see games like this along with games like we had the other night where we played against VTC and we had a game where, like, I think there was 12 kills in 30 minutes.
Yeah.
Because we played it so slow because we were scaling for late. And then you get games like this and, like, how crazy it is our league can, you know, play completely different styles of games.
I feel like if my team, if we play... We play really well playing towards the late game. If we can get a really good scaling comp, I feel like it's really hard for us to, like, lose. We like our team fights. But if we try to skirmish early on, I feel like that's kind of where our weakness is just around the skirmishing, being able to rotate soon enough. And it looks like both these teams are really comfortable with that. So, like, you know, they're taking every opportunity to fight and, like, I can imagine it's like Papa Bear is like, hey, I got someone on me, like, and Young Gun's like, don't mind me, let me use my mobility boots, and just scurries right over there, and then boom, like, they're also engaged into the fight very quickly. It's definitely a different, like, experience, because I do not remember our games kind of going like this more recently.
Yeah, I don't think I've had a game this crazy where, you know, it's 2 kills a minute, but we've definitely had our fair share of skirmishy type games and then some longer scale to late games.
Oh, is that you, Oliver? Oliver? Nah, he doesn't want to say hello. He just wants to meow from far away. Do you have any pets, John?
Yeah, I do. I have a cat.
Oh, nice.
His name's Liam. I'm sure several people in this stream have probably heard me talking to him because he gets on my desk all the time and stands between my keyboard and the monitor and tries to coach me, you know?
Yeah, right. Oh, I have an announcement to make. This is breaking news for the stream. Well, it's not breaking news because it happened a couple hours ago. But, you know, I'm happy to share a proud achievement for myself here. I just got to Diamond on Team TFT just before these matches started up. Yeah, pretty happy about that. Now I can go back to my solo queue grinding so I can make myself sad again.
Well, congrats on Diamond. I've not been Diamond in TFT for a while, but I've been there before, so definitely a big achievement.
The last time I was Diamond was back in set 6. I don't think I made it back in the mid set. I think I made it set 6, and so. I was looking back because I was talking to Klug, actually, about doing Miss the Cat's
Blue Water League.
Yeah.
Yeah.
And he was like, oh, like, I think you had to be Diamond from 6.5 on. And I checked my stats, and I remember being not there. I was like, I was it just recently, but no, it was at set 6.
Yeah, it was the same thing. It was the same thing for me because I'm doing Mr. Cat's TFT as well. I did it when it first started, and I was Diamond set 6 as well, and so that's the last time I'd hit Diamond. Other than that, I've been Plat, so I'm having to play in the what we're calling the Mystic Kittens division.
Nice, I like it. The whiskey.
It was actually supposed to start today, but didn't happen, so gotta see what's happening with that.
Hook had a power outage.
looks like his router's restarting, so.
That's good. Yeah, if I'm correct, we may be like pretty much right on time with everybody else. Of course, that we wouldn't be in this pause timer. I think otherwise, but kind of cool. We're with the teams and this moment probably feels all too real. It's kind of crazy, you know, things like this. So, you know, a football game, like someone gets injured, like you're on that drive and, you know, you're right there about to like score or something, and then you have to sit out for like 10-15 minutes. You know, you kind of cool down, the adrenaline cools down. So I wonder how that's going to affect both of these teams. To me, they've just been so like hyped, amped up, like taking as many fights as they can. I'm curious to see when they return, if they're going to kind of, he's reconnected. If they're going to be like amped up, ready to go, still making these fights happen, or if they're going to be a lot more measured, a lot more careful. We're not going to see kills happen for another 4 minutes right before this Drake. I don't know. We'll see.
Yeah, see if maybe they had some time to like think about it and say, hey, maybe we should slow this game down. Maybe we should do this, you know, strategize a little bit. Or if they just decide, you know, this is the best thing for our team, decide to keep fighting. So definitely be interesting to see what they have figured out during this pause.
Totally forgot I had food, too. I'm going to start chomping away.
Also, yes, Super Huggy, some people have thought that Liam was my son when I talked about him. I've had at least two people think that. But no, I do not have any children. I only have furry ones.
So it looks like they, at some point, if this is live, it's live, but if not, they were asking for 5 more minutes, because I know that they know that the rules say 15 minutes. And I should know this. I'm on the admin team. I haven't looked at the rule set in terms of this, but that 15-minute timer, what does that actually mean in terms of this matchup? Okay, there's not an unpause after 15 minutes. What happens?
They just have to. So if they don't give them the time, they just have to unpause and play it as a 4v5.
Gotcha. Okay.
Which Dadbot Gaming did give them extra time.
Okay.
I've never seen someone be like, no, we're going to keep playing this game. So.
Yeah. I'm curious how something like this would play out in the Blue Otter League.
I'm assuming they have their own rule set, probably. You know, it's not like LCS where they can, you know, just wait forever or have someone, you know, replace them or replay the match or anything like that.
Right.
We did see Hook, my book, reconnect, but they're saying that he's not back and not functional, so I don't know if he's still having issues with Discord or what exactly is going on. It looks like he's in the Discord, so probably just waiting on maybe some, uh,
Feel free to hop over there if you want to see.
Yeah, I might go see what's going on and see if it's going to be how much longer. Maybe go to like ads or something or just play some music. I'm running out of stuff to talk about, honestly.
Yeah, me too.
I'll be right back. I'm going to see.
Sounds good.
What they think.
In the meantime, I'm going to crank up some of this music that we've been listening to. Probably going to skip over this.
All right, so they should be unpausing really soon.
Okay, great.
Playing Panda, Brandon Hook My Book had a power outage and Spectrum is messing with his stuff, so that's why we have a 17-minute delay. Just blame Spectrum. It's the easiest. Because they always have problems. He said he got hit with the Spectrum maintenance. I don't have Spectrum, so I don't know what that means. I don't know if it... what all happens there, but,
Yeah. They don't do a good job, like, letting us know when maintenance happens. Oh!
Back in game.
Here we go, everybody. Back into this match. I mean, it's been so long, I don't even remember the last thing that just happened. I hit a little bit of a... Are you kind of glitched out here?
Yeah, at 27:18.
Yes, okay.
Yep.
Alright, I'm curious what that's all about.
Did it just unpause?
Yeah.
Okay, yeah, it's probably something to do with spectate. Since we're both getting it at the same times.
Right, Mr. Trifecta is sitting here on two items now. He's got the Riftmaker. Caitlin on three items. Jinx is, like we mentioned, is really close to this LDR. Morgana without the stopwatch. So probably really close to finishing off that item. He's just missing the codex and however much gold is more than that. Maybe I think it's like 150. So, as of right now, looks like both teams have kind of slowed down a little bit. They're clearing out vision. These are some of the things we weren't seeing before. Like, I don't remember them seeing them clear out vision. And, okay, another disconnection by Hook My Book. He's reconnected again. I could say that would probably affect a little bit of like my pacing and my mental, because it's like kind of probably makes you a little bit scared of like whether or not you can commit to an engagement without, you know, being put in a situation where it's like, oh, now we're here with the pause. You know, if it's in the middle of a team fight, it's that's going to affect the game, because then you're gonna have more time to think about what's happening in between the team fight. Mentioned before, both teams just clearing out vision.
Looks like they have decided to slow down a little bit on the fighting, at least.
Oh, they just glossed over a ward there. I don't know if they caught it on the scanner. Okay.
Looks like they're just going to let Trundle split and not match him. Looks like they just want to fight around Baron. And
yep.
Force the TP.
Okay, here we go. Here's an engagement. Q's going to land. They're going to pop that GA. I think Caitlyn's going to get her ultimate back. I'm not sure. Nah, she's not. That's a double kill over to the Caitlyn. It's an and that there you have it. They're going to be forcing this Baron play. Trundle's going to push in. He already got one turret. He's going to maybe try and pick up this inhib turret. Baron with the assist, stopping the teleport from the Gwyn. Trundle's not going to be able to get this inhibitor turret. There's another TP coming in by Klug. They didn't stop that back, but they're going to be able to get this inhib turret on the bot side. Now, are they going to escape with their lives? Q's going to land by Nivea. Okay, we got drag spawning up in 30 seconds.
Yeah, that is infernal. So, like we were talking about, like, you want to see this if you're the side of DBG, but you don't want to give it over if you're naturally dangerous.
And they're not going to give it over. They just got Trundle over the wall. Are they going to be able to take him out quick enough? Oh! Jinx Rocket connects, and it's going to pop the Zac passive. Mr. Trifecta using his ultimate. He's trying to go for a fight, but he's caught himself out. He's going to die. Three kills make that four kills going into the favor of Naturally Dangerous. This game has swung again. Caitlyn forced to back off, take a back, and now we have second Drake being picked up by the blue squad. This is exactly what you want if you're Naturally Dangerous. So, even though they slowed down the game just a little bit, the character is all there. They're engaging the same way, and both these teams are finding strengths and weaknesses on both sides of the map. I'm curious. I almost want to go back and like see, like, okay, in terms of the Baron plays and the top side plays, who was more successful, you know, red team or blue team, and then vice versa, who's been more acceptable, who's been more successful on the bot side or the blue side objectives, the bot side objectives. So. Zac XDR.
Hey, do you see backup pings coming from Zac?
Red team?
Caitlyn's the only one with Baron.
Yeah, so they really have to kind of stick with her. EQ combo coming out. Mr. Trifecta nearly half health now. W is going to land by No Not November. It's going to force Caitlyn to kind of back it up. Keep trying to catch some of this CS. Well measured. They're very patient on the side of Naturally Dangerous, and I think they feel very confident in control right now. Klug is less than half health, but he doesn't seem to be threatened right now. But he's going to step up. Engagement is going to hit onto Klug, but the damage is not there. Not November picking up a double kill. Make that triple. It's so close. Okay. The shutdown going on to Hook My Book. That has to feel good. You know, to disconnect and kind of put this game in commission for a little while. But come back, be able to get a good kill, a good shutdown. It looks like they might be able to close this game out. A lot of damage coming through. Hook My Book dies, but that's another double kill over to No Not November, and they're going to finish this game at 35 minutes. What a quick turnaround.
Yeah, they found the fight they needed and decided to pressure around that Baron when they knew that they were going to take it and what was going to happen, so. And, side of Dabo Gaming tried responding to it, but you saw Baron knocking up Mr. Trifecta. So that ended up being a huge, huge turning point for them.
Two really good games from both teams. And Book, I hear you, man. I wish to say fuck Spectrum. Thanks. Yeah, can we get some Spectrums in the chat? Yes, please bring those in. I don't know how it works in terms of mods, but I'm not gonna say it. 1-1 for both teams. I wonder where these puts both these teams inside the standings. Looking at game two, what would you say? Who's MVP?
I think I'm gonna say Nature Dan.
Nature Dan.
He was the one that caused a lot of that split push problem. And I'm assuming that he's the one who said, you know, I know they're taking Baron, I'm just gonna push down bot lane, and got that inhib, and then was able to find damage onto Papa Bear to get him low enough to pop his passive, and that's what started that whole Drake fight. And then you saw basically the entire Baron of DBG go down the drain with that fight.
Yeah.
But I think that just being the huge turning point, I think that for me is going to be MVP. If I had to choose a second, though, I'd say Zach XDRK had some really big cataclysms in those fights as well.
Well, we're going to make a new poll. And I always like seeing a good one-for-one happening. On a matchup, it just really great that both teams can like adapt and be able to pull out a win. All right. Poll going up. Game 2 MVP, please vote. And be happy to get a member from both teams to join us. We can have Rob go ahead and join us. We can talk about his thoughts and impressions on game 1. If he's here, would like to join us. And then looks like we have 3 members of Naturally Dangerous left. I mean, I don't care. All 3 of y'all are welcome to join us if you'd like.
I'd say let's just get the MVPs and then coaches from the teams if they want to join. We don't want to get too many people in here and get a huge conversation going.
I can respect that it's a late game on a Sunday night, and it looks like, yeah, there's only 3 people left on the Discord. I think a lot of people might have went back to bed. But according to the poll, we have 3 votes in so far. Nature Dan in the lead. on my way to Pog chat. All right, come on, come on, come on. Oh, wait, I can't. They can't join. I have to. Here, let's go down to Nature League Dangerous.
Hey, we can just go to Player of the Game. They can see those.
Oh, yeah, okay. Player That's of the
what,
Game.
Yeah.
Yeah, let's do that. Okay. Oh. Oh, okay. There we go. There we go. Welcome, Nature Dan.
Hello, hello, hello.
Justin, no, not November. How y'all doing?
Hello.
God.
Ooga booga. Ooga booga. Yeah, congratulations on the win. And great adaptation going into game two.
Thank you.
Yeah. Cool. I want to know your thoughts, both game one, game two. Feel free to keep it brief. I know it's really late, so.
Yeah. Game one. Our general thought was approaching with a fairly standard pick comp. Dadbod Gaming was able to do a great job with what became that three-man goon squad, the Amumu, Nunu, and Malphite, and just started causing a lot of havoc around different parts of the map. And they played the team fights. They saved the team fights to the point where we clearly had to take off the Malphite and the Ahri going into game two. So great job to Dadbot Gaming on game number one. That was definitely some unfortunate positioning and some really rough times for us. So they trust me, they made us work for it.
That they did. Going into the game two, how did y'all feel? I feel like that was a very hectic, chaotic game, only because as Symphony and John here was saying, it was nearly, if not more, of two kills a minute or for the game. So
there was the game plan. Where DC'd, he died, so that happened.
So the DC didn't help, but it was a hectic game. But believe it or not, it was actually kind of we knew there was a lot of kills, there was a lot of fights going on. In a lot of places we were training. The team was able to sit down, breathe, discuss, and ultimately identified on our more late game approach as the draft, all the way from the draft. We knew that our team and relative to theirs was going to have the late game answer, and so that was kind of the approach to that. And it was a hectic game. There were a lot of fights, but I'll admit, I think on the terms of like the kills per minute, I think it was a little heavy loaded to some of those big team fights around the 25-30 minutes around the big objectives, especially before the Dadbod Gaming got their third dragon, if my memory serves me correct, although that thing's been going every day since forever.
Well, thank you for sharing.
I would like to clarify one thing. It was not ultimately my decision in terms of split pushing. I got to hand it to the rest of my team, especially Mr. Klug, who is regularly in my ear telling me exactly what I need to do and when I need to do it. I am simply the tool to which he uses.
Very nice, very nice. I mean, that's teamwork in a lot of ways. Cool. Symphony and John, do you have any questions?
No, you pretty much asked what I was going to ask, so.
Okay. Well, once again,
If I may, quick shout out to both Brandon and Justin, who were able to sub for us pseudo last minute, but they were able to sub and played wonderfully with the team. So we always appreciate them, and every time someone's got to jump in and sub for a team, that's always appreciated. And great game to Dadbod Gaming. This is twice we've gone with them 1-1 matchup, and so I look forward to the next time we get to go 1-1 with them.
Absolutely. Congratulations, everybody. Well, cool. I'm gonna go ahead and wrap things up here. Everyone have a good night. Congratulations both teams on winning a game and bringing the series to 1-1.
Thank you.
Yeah.